Okay. Good day, everyone. This is Engineer Armando Omanito, and our topic for today is closed traverse under the subject plane surveying. So let's have the problem. A closed traverse has the following data. So we have here the data for the closed traverse. We have lines A, B, B, C, C, D, D, E, N, E, A, and its corresponding bearings and distances. So we have the question. Number one, compute the bearing of line DE. Number two, compute the bearing of line EA. Number three, compute the area of the lot. So here, we are going to find the missing bearings of two different lines. Okay. So let's have the solution. So first, we have to draw the approximate figure of this closed traverse by using the given data. So we have AB, line AB is here, and the bearing is south 35 degrees 30 minutes west. So this is line AB, and line BC is northwest. So northwest, so that is in the second quadrant. Okay. So, it has its distance and bearing. And then line CD, we also have the distance and bearing here. But in line DE, we are only given the distance. And the bearing is missing. And in line EA, the same with line DE, we are also given the distance but with missing bearing. Okay. So, the next thing to do is to get the resultant of the lines with complete or with given bearings and distances. So, and those lines are line AB, okay, this one line AB and line BC, okay, here, and line CD. Here. So this is the approximate resultant of these three lines. Okay. So now we will get the resultant. So we will use the Caltech formula rec r theta. Okay. Okay. So we will now get the corresponding x and y components of line AB, BC, and CD. Okay. So, in line AB, so we will use, okay. So, let us now clear our calculator. And then, let us press shift, this one, and then this rectangular button. Okay, or the minus sign. Okay. And then, we will input the distance of line AB, which is 44.37. Okay. And then, let us press shift and comma here. Okay. And then, we will use the corresponding complementary angle of the bearing of AB. Okay. So, and that will be 90, and then press this degree sign, and then minus the bearing of AB, which is 35 degrees and 30 minutes. Okay, press this one, and then press the close parenthesis, okay, and then press the equal sign. And we will have the answer to be negative 25.76579. Okay, and also for the value of y, we have 36.12231. Okay, so here we don't have the negative sign, but as you can see, line AB is in the third quadrant. Okay, so in the third quadrant, the signs of x and y are both negative. So that's why we have a both negative values of x and y component of line AB. So the same with line BC. So again, let us clear our calculator and then let us input the given data for line BC. So let us input, so for the value of R, we will input the distance of line BC. So we have 137, okay, point, we have 84, okay, and then press shift, comma, here. And then input the corresponding complementary angle of line BC, and that is 90 degrees sine minus 57 degrees, okay, 15 minutes. And then press this close parenthesis here, okay, and press the equal sign. Oh, wait. So we have 137. Okay, wait. Ah, we did not press the, okay, shift rec, alright. Shift, and then this rec, okay. So now, let us press the equal sign, okay. And then, we have the answer to be, so negative 115.92881. So, negative because, as you can see, line BC is in the second quadrant. And the x component here in the second quadrant is negative. And then for the value of y, so press this arrow here, we have 74.56792. And that is positive. Okay. And then for line CD, the same procedure. So, press this shift and then rectangular button. And then, press 12.83 and then shift comma and then the corresponding complementary angle, which is 90 degrees minus 1 degree degree sine and then 45 minutes degree sine. Okay, and then press this close parenthesis and press the equal sign. Okay, and we have the value for x and y to be, so for x we have 0.39181. Okay. And for y, we have 12.82. Okay. Let us press this arrow here. So, 12.82 for 1. For 02. 82 for 02. Okay. So, both x and y components are positive because, as you can see, line CD is in the first quadrant. Okay. So, upon solving for the x and y component of lines AB, BC, and CD, we will get the summation of their x components and its y components. So, we will add negative 25 for line AB, negative 25.76 and so on. And for line BC, we have negative 115.92 and so on. And then for line CD, we have 0.3918, and the total is, or summation of x is equal to negative 141.3028. And for the summation of y components, we have negative 36.12231 for line AB, and then for line BC, okay, 74 point something, and then for line CD, we have 12.82402. And the summation of y, or sum of the y components is equal to 51.26963. So we will get the value of the resultant by getting the square root of the sum of the squares of the summations of x and y, and that will be square root of summation of x squared plus summation of y squared. Okay, and then substitute the value for the summation of x. Okay, which is negative 141 and something, close parenthesis squared, plus the summation of y, 51.26963, close parenthesis. And that will give us R to be 150.31652. And then we will solve for the bearing of this resultant. Okay. So to solve for the bearing of the resultant, we will use summation of x over summation of y. Okay, So because summation of x over summation of y, because we are looking for the bearing, and that will be summation of x is, so disregarding the sign, is 141.3028 and 51.26963, and that will give us tangent theta to be equal to 2.73657. Okay, and we will continue this video in we will continue this topic on the next video.